Welcome to the Virtual Challenge Show, a skating contest for the age of social distancing. I'm Lady Trample, and I'll be your host this morning, afternoon, evening, wherever you are in the world. Let's get to meet our guests. Awesome. All right. So today we have four very exciting skaters. We're going to do a little brief intro and get to know them a little bit better. Up top on the left, we have Audrey. On the right, we have Jess. On the bottom right, we have Jenny. And the bottom left, we have Bambi. So Audrey has been skating for 7 years and is currently located in Denver, Colorado. Jess has 8 years under her belt and is located in Penzance in the UK. Bambi has been skating somewhere between 8 and 9 years. 2011, I think, is where we ended up. And she's currently located in Des Moines, Iowa. And Jenny has 4 years under her belt and is located in Greeley, Colorado. Audrey, can you tell us how you started to skate?
I joined roller derby in El Paso, Texas. Loved it, and then switched to parks a couple years ago, and then just got completely hooked.
That's awesome. And can you tell us about some of the parks you currently skate in?
So I'm in the Mazing, Colorado, state of Colorado now. Though I miss my ditches from El Paso, Texas. So there's so many features. There's probably hundreds of parks. So I'm super lucky. I kind of hit maybe five to eight, like every week.
That's incredible. And Jess, how did you start skating?
I started roller derby about 8 years ago. And then just got into park skating. And yeah, just ditched the roller derby and carried on skating parks.
Fell in love and never looked back. I love it.
Yeah.
And can you tell us a bit about where you currently skate?
In Penzance, there's two skate parks. One's only a few minutes from my home, and the other's, I don't know, a little bit further. My most local one is the bowl that you see me skate pretty much in all my Instagram stuff. And the other one's a little plaza on the seafront. But we don't have like that many skate parks here in Cornwall. And once there are, they're all quite like spaced apart. You've got like travel to the different parks. We're not blessed like you guys are in the state.
I feel like we see you get pretty creative with your locations and kind of taking it to the streets quite a bit.
Definitely got to work with it.
That's awesome. Katie, can you tell us how you got into skating?
So similar story for me. I started playing roller derby and played that for a really long time. But pretty soon after I started doing parks, and I have been doing that ever since. And that's kind of been my biggest love lately.
And what kind of skating obstacles do you have access to?
So in Des Moines, we have a lot of small parks that are farther out from the city, but they're actually in the process of building a really big skate park in our town, and the bowls are getting poured like right now. It was supposed to be open in last year, but now they're thinking this fall. So I'm really, really hoping for that, because I usually have to travel to skate bigger, better skate parks.
Well, that's awesome. I can't wait to see what you came up with for this. And Jenny, can you tell us how you got into skating?
Well, like everybody else, I too dipped my toes into roller derby. Didn't last very long, but then you actually did a ramp clinic in Fort Collins, Colorado that I went to. And I ditched derby and all I do is parks now.
Well, I have no regrets about that. I remember that session. And can you tell us about some of the parks that you skate locally?
Yeah, so I actually live in a tiny cow town outside of Greeley. I hit all the parks in Northern Colorado, which every 30 miles you have a new park. So I go all over the place and it's a good time.
Awesome. All right. Well, we're going to get to know you four a bit better throughout this, but without any further ado, let's get into our category. So this week we introduce a category of grabs. We set some pretty awesome tricks for these skaters to tackle. Every skater was sent the same list of tricks and descriptions, and they had 7 days to lace up and submit their clips. The very first trick we're going to be looking into is the cannonball grab, which is an air where you tuck and grab both your skates at the front, aiming to grab around your knees. Let's see how our skaters took this one on. Awesome. All right, so that was Audrey. Next up, we got Jess. Nice. Oh, wow. Sweet. All right, so now we're going to head into trick talk and talk a little bit about these clips that we just saw. Also, this week we have the ability to play around with some fun extras. I know that we have some pretty fun slams and potentially some slow motions as well to look at. So let's start off with Audrey's clip and see what we have. Nice. Audrey, have you done many cannonballs before? Is this a trick you're familiar with?
Actually, no. I think I've maybe attempted it twice.
Oh, you look like a natural at it. I mean, you got the nice tuck and everything.
It took me probably 100 tries just to hold on to it for that long.
I feel like it's really, when I personally do grabs, I'm really good at getting like a slap grab in, but you've got the full grip going on, so good job on that. And let's check out the clip from Jess. Now, am I right in saying that you alley-ooped this one?
Yeah.
Awesome. And do you have any tips for skaters wanting to try a cannonball?
Not really. Just tuck your knees.
Well, it looks like you absolutely nailed that one. And let's check out Bambi's clip. Also, I just want to point out that the slow motion with your hair is freaking fabulous. Now, I feel like I've seen you do this trick before. Is this something that you would consider in your repertoire?
Yeah, this is one I've done a few times, usually more in bowls or on a vert ramp. So it was fun to try this in this little mini thing. And yeah, I had fun. I think I might have sent in a version 2 where I do add in a turn, and that was like me trying to level it up for myself.
Oh, sweet. Let's check out the alternate. Oh, wow.
That was nice. A little harder to get the grab, but.
Yeah. Awesome. And let's finish up checking out Jenny's clip. Sweet. So Jenny, is this a trick that you're familiar with?
No, so I actually have done it once ever. But I really like airing right here on this thing. It's like a 6-foot platform on the top there. I was really aiming to get all the way to the end, but I just missed like the last foot. But no, it was definitely a new one for me.
And I believe we have a bail clip for you for this one. Should we check it out? You want to tell us what happened?
Sure.
You want to talk about it?
Well, let's look at it first.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, so I really have no idea. there's a couple where I kept my legs behind me. I don't know. The sides of my legs are all bloodied. Like, they're all scabbed up now, so.
Well, thank you for doing that for us. It's highly entertaining, and I'm glad that you're okay. All right, so do any of you have questions for each other that you want to fire out? There's no pressure, don't worry. All right, well, in that case, we'll move on to the first round. Yeah, no, the I like that you all took slightly different approaches in terms of rotations. So we had a 360, we had an air over a gap, we had an alley-oop, and we had a backside air. So everyone's kind of put their own spin or not on it. Let's head into the first round of voting. So I'm going to just talk to our audience for a second about how to vote. Everyone will have roughly 2 minutes to comment the skater's name. And for those of you watching live, every vote counts for 1 point, and these votes will accumulate throughout the show. Most points at the end will win best in show. Remember that you can only vote once per trick, so choose your vote and make it count, and we will see you back here in a couple of minutes. Welcome back. Thank you everyone for voting in that last category. So we just closed off the cannonballs, which means that we are heading into trick number two, which is the judo air. And a judo air is a air grabbing your back skate heel and kicking your front foot forward. So let's head over and see how our skaters took this trick on. Oh, wow. Over the spine, Jenny. Very nice. All right, let's head into trick talk and talk about what we just saw. So let's start off with Audrey's clip, and I believe that we've got a nice big slow motion of this. So Audrey, was this your first time doing the judo air?
I'd been practicing it as a hand plant. So this was my first day and a lot of angry moments this day, but I feel like I kind of got it, but this was the first day that I really practiced it without planting.
And can I ask if you have any tips after a day of frustrating attempts for anyone that might want to try this trick?
Take a lot of breathers. maybe a beer or two.
Solid advice.
And oh yeah, and really, really just kick that like left leg. That was my, I couldn't control my leg that day, but this was the best one I got.
That's awesome. That's a great freeze frame on that. All right, let's check out Jess's clip again. Very nice. And it looks like you've gone, let's see that again in slow motion. So same question for you, Jess. Is this one that you're familiar with or an air that you have done before?
Yeah, it's one I really quite like. It's one of my go-to tricks. But it really annoys me sometimes when I can't get my leg straight. It just won't straighten up. I like that. It really annoys me. It's a love-hate trick, this one. When you get it,
I have the same
really
problem.
Nice. Otherwise, I'm like, it's my legs bent.
Well, it looks like you've done a really good job of sort of reaching around to grab that back skate. Do you have any tips for anyone that might be trying this one? We've got beers as a tip from Audrey. Yeah, what's your sort of go-to?
Yeah, I go with beers.
Yeah, all right, so I've got beers and beers.
Beers and beers.
All right, let's head over and yes, as you were.
Yeah, no, I just really try and grab and tuck that leg under, like try and grab it to your bum. But people do it all different ways, so I was really interested to see what everybody's styles and ways of doing this trick were. Because I do it like
absolutely.
That, some people do it completely differently, so...
It's very fun to see the different interpretations. All right, let's check out Bambi's tricks. Nice, and it looks like you have opted for a backside air as well. Bambi, can you tell us if this is a trick you're familiar with or is this new to the repertoire?
This is one I'm familiar with, but I don't pull it out too often because it was like one of the, for some reason, kind of scarier this time for me. But yeah, it was fun.
And I think we have an alternate clip for this one as well. So let's check it out. Looks like you've done a really great job of getting that grab to happen, really. And any tips for skaters wanting to try this one? So far we've had beer. And really tuck it. Any PG-13 tips for those that might be, you know, below the drinking
age? Yes. I'm going to give advice, but I'm knowing it's advice that I need to take better myself, and that's to ride the ramp all the way up before jumping and grabbing anything. So I'm watching myself on these like, oh, why did I jump so early? Like, I know I'd be way boostier if I rode that ramp all the way up, and that's going to give you maximum time to tuck and grab.
Massive support for that advice. I am very guilty of leaving too soon, and so hearing that is awesome. Jess, it looks like you've got a hook.
Yeah, just thought, one thing I always do before I go in, for whatever trick it is set up, practice it, like go through the motions before I even go into the bowl or into the ramp. So I know sort of it's that like muscle memory of what you're going to do when you get into the air. So I often look like a right wally standing on the edge, like perched, balancing, doing all the different movements. But it's sort of, it's in there then for when you go into the air.
No, that makes total sense. I do the same thing when I practice the seatbelt grab. I'll stand on the side and just kind of like do a bunch of dunks with my arms and, you know, stretch out the muscles so that the first time I'm trying to get that reach to happen, it's not in the air. That is solid advice. All right, and let's check out Jenny's clip. Over the spine. Damn, that is impressive. Now, I do know Jenny, and I know that Jenny loves a spine, but can you tell me what made you want to do this trick over a spine? Because I think that's just absolutely bonkers.
Easy, one word, havoc. So what was it, 2 years ago at RollerCon? I saw Havoc do it, and I went up to her and I said, wow, that's amazing. I want to do that. And she's, I asked for a tip, and she goes, at that point, she told me that she doesn't grab. She just does it with the legs, which typically that's really how I do it. So adding the grab in again for this was kind of a challenge. But no, I just saw her do it, and I was like, that is amazing. And then I started throwing it there. So.
That's mighty impressive. And I will say I'm actually very opposite to you, because normally when I see Havoc do something, it makes me not want to do it because I realize how crazy it is. So knowing that you saw Havoc do it and then you went, actually, that's something I also want to do, just proves how different we are. But I love you all the more for it. Audrey, was that a hook that we saw?
Oh, yeah, totally. I just want to also note to the viewers that this spine is massive. So you are a champ.
Yeah, it's like 6 foot. Is that right?
I think so.
And I believe we also have a bail again for Jenny. So let's check out this bail reel. Okay, that's not too bad. That's less, a pretty controlled bail.
Yeah, so I'd say it's less a bail and more of a. Here's a tip for that. If you jump before you hit the top of the spine, you land at the bottom of the transition on the other side.
That's a great tip. So again, being patient and making sure that you're riding it out, not rushing those movements.
Yeah.
Awesome. All right. And on that note, we will close up this round and head to another round of voting. So again, to our live viewers, it's time to vote. You're going to have around 2 minutes. Be sure to comment the name of the skater that you think nailed this trick the best. The comment and the vote is worth one, and you can only vote once per category. So get in there, drop those names, and we will see you back here in a few minutes. Welcome back, everyone, and thank you for voting for our our judo air. We are now moving into trick number 3, which is in fact the method grab. So let's check out that trick description. An air, grabbing your heels, straightening your hips, and pulling your skates up behind your back. I will start off by saying this is a mighty hard grab to commit to, so I cannot wait to see how our skaters took this one on. Oh, sweet. Awesome. And let's head into Trick Talk and find out a little bit more about these takes. So, Audrey, am I right in saying that you did like an air to fakie, but you were traveling across the transition while doing that?
Totally. I definitely wanted to add a lot of lateral movement, and it was the hardest part about it.
That is awesome. And is this a grab that you're familiar with?
I tried it once and failed when it first came out as a CIB trick of the month. And so magically when this was assigned to me, I was like, all right, I'm gonna kick one out for real.
Well, that's awesome. It looks like you had a lot of fun with that one. Well, we got some snaps going on from it. I thought we had a hook. I love it. Let's check out Jess's take. Oh, I'm so sorry. Actually, I just realized we have a bail from you, Audrey. Let's check this out. Yeah. I want to see your slams. Oh, nice. Yeah, I feel like that's inevitable when airing to fakie. You okay? You still got all your limbs?
Got a nice little bruise right here.
Oh, Zolbo.
Scab picking.
Very nice. Awesome. All right, now let's go check out Jess's clips. And that looks like a backside air. Again, Jess, is this a grab that you're familiar with?
It is one I'm familiar with. I don't do them very often at all. And I've had a really sore back. So this was the worst possible one you could have sent, but it set us to do.
I am sorry. It's pretty mean. It's a tough grab. It's one that I personally really, really struggle with. So I thought it would be a great challenge to set for y'all. And I think we also have a bail for Jess. So let's check that one out. Oh, no, that looks like that was a make.
It was a make, but it's one I wasn't happy with my form. I felt like I did a really nice grab that held on for a nice time that I was really pleased with, but I didn't feel like my legs were back enough.
Yeah,
so I had to keep going back to the skate park and trying again.
with this grab, the whole idea is to really like, you probably can't see on camera, but it's to really kind of puff your body forward and pull your legs back. So I can see the difference between the two clips you sent through, but I do love that you're very nitpicky with it, but I mean, that's hardly a bail. Those are both makes in my books. Let's head over and check out Bambi's clips. Love it. And it looks like you've gone for a one-handed, and that is that a backside rotation that you're going for?
Yes.
And is this a trick that you're familiar with?
No, this is the one when I got the list that I was like the most nervous for. And I'm like, I cannot do that. There's no way. So I was grateful to have this one to push me out of my comfort zone and try something new. I definitely like when I see people do this that like I want to emulate, they have that like crazy curve in their back and they're pulling their feet up. So I have that image to channel for future. Then definitely want to do, I got to do a lot of yoga and boost a little higher for sure.
Yeah, you have to be fully balanced inside and out to try this one. Do you have any tips for anyone that's wanting to try it other than a little bit of meditation beforehand?
This one I'll definitely encourage to just go for it because it looks harder. I think it is really hard, but it looks a lot more intimidating than it felt, I think. So grab those feet and push your hips forward.
Thrust. Love it.
Thrust.
And let's finish off checking out Jenny's clips. Nice. So you've gone for an air to fakie, and it looks like you got nice height on that one too. All the way up. Is this a trick that you're familiar with?
So this one I learned when the CIB Trick of the Month came out with it. And that was the first time I had done it. I don't really do it other than that because, like Jess, I have a really bad back, and it is a brutal one for the back for sure.
I know. I actually, you got mad at me when I sent you the trick list for this one, so I'm sorry. But it's good to see you doing it. We got a hook from Audrey.
So awesome. But a huge tip that worked for me was I can't snowboard worth a lick, but I watched a bunch of snowboarders do it and they just nail this trick so hard. So that's like huge inspiration and like a huge tip is like how I got like the lateral movement because I saw it in some snowboarding ones.
That's awesome. I love that you're checking out like cross disciplines and transferring, because I think a lot of these movements exist in many different sports. And so taking inspiration from other ones is really great advice. And I believe that, Jenny, you have just delivered the goods. And 3 out of 3, we have another bale. So let's check that out. And we're going to come back to your hook. Don't you worry, Jess. Oh, no. Okay. That's not supposed to happen.
So,
we got double bail for this round.
This one kicked my butt pretty hard. The first one was a case in point as don't jump, just lift. I obviously jumped away and again landed at the bottom of the transition.
Yep.
And this one came towards the end of all my attempts. And then the one where my foot gets hooked, that one, I was actually going for the method to a late stall, which I have done before, but my first attempt, that's what I did. And I couldn't get past it. So I never did end up to try again, but
That's fair. And so for those of you watching from home, a late stall is when you do an air of some kind and then you land on the coping afterwards. And it is a super tricky trick. So that would have been one heck of an up for that. But thank you for trying. And I'm sorry that you had such a big slam for those, double slam for this trick. Thank you for sharing those with us. Jess, you had a hook just before we headed to the section. Is it still relevant?
Yeah. Just another little tip, which is that you tilt your head, so you're looking up when you go to grab. So as well as pushing out your hip, you look up, so you're not looking down at the ground. You're trying to put your head up.
That totally makes sense. It just helps kind of push your body forward and open your chest, because I feel like part of this movement is actually allowing your shoulders to go back. And so by lifting that neck up, that's going to help complete that movement. That is awesome advice. Does anyone...
Doesn't mean I did it.
You don't have to always, you know, sometimes I give advice that I'm giving to myself as much as I am to anybody else. Are there any more little trick tips or tidbits that you want to share before we close off this round?
No,
all right, Chatty Cathys, we will head into the round of voting. So again, to our viewers, you will have 2 minutes to comment the name of the skater that you think nailed this trick the best. Each vote counts for 1 point, and they are accumulating throughout the show. So we will see you back here in about 2 minutes. Welcome back, and thank you all for voting for that last round of Method Grabs. We have one final round to share with you all, and this is always my favorite round. This is the freestyle round, which is an opportunity for these skaters to get creative and show us what their skating is all about. So the parameter set for this was it has to be a grab, and that was literally it. So let's see how these skaters took on the freestyle round, and I believe we're going to start off with Audrey's clip.
Cool.
That's fun. I can't wait to look at that again. Oh, I know what this one is.
Ah, dope.
begin with the spine. Awesome. All right, let's talk about these clips. So we're going to start off with Audrey. Let's see what we've got going on here. I believe I saw a silly face. Yes.
So cute.
Can you tell us what we're looking at here? This is great.
I'm going to call this one the giddy up.
Yeah.
I thought it was kind of fun. Kind of fun to do. I almost pulled out my skate leash to do it. But I submitted a couple. And I honestly just had super fun getting full Cindy on this hip here.
That's awesome. And so we're calling, what did you say you were calling this one? The rodeo?
Rodeo or giddy up, either or.
Giddy up. Giddy up. I would love to see people get creative with Photoshop with this one here, because this is a very fun freeze frame. And I believe we also have a bale for this, so let's check out that bale.
Oh, no.
Oh.
Thanks for that. That was me full time trying not to break my phone that I've broken 3 times already.
Oh, no. I know what that's like, especially luckily it was just your phone and not a person holding it. There's nothing worse than when you lose control and just go flying towards the person that's, you know, very kindly offering to shoot your stuff. So that is
oh,
awesome.
Luckily,
we're gonna
I have those too.
Luckily, yeah. Let's move on to Jess's clip. Now, if I'm correct, I believe we're seeing a pretzel grab. And if I'm also correct, I believe that, Jess, you are the inventor behind this awesome, very twisty. Can you tell us what inspired you to even try this movement?
It was Jeff Grosso with his roast beef grab that inspired me to try this. I just wanted to elaborate on it because I love doing a roast beef. And I just wanted to see if I could elaborate on it. So it made sense to just shove a seatbelt in there as well. So that's basically
that is awesome.
The combination, roast beef and a seatbelt. And then it looks like
so
a
the
pretzel,
roast beef,
apparently.
The roast beef is the hand that's going behind, is that correct? And the seatbelt is
yeah.
the one that's going across in front. So you've
across.
Basically taken two grabs and smushed them together and somehow managed to pull it off in a single go. That is just, Yeah, that is a crazy move. It's so fun and inspiring seeing you doing that. So thank you for sharing that with us. And let's check out Bambi's clip. And I believe that you have not done an air, but you've gone for a slide or a grind. Is that what we're seeing? Let's check it out again.
Yes, you know me. I could not resist going to grind down. Or a roll,
nice.
I guess. I'm actually rolling
yeah.
on the coping in this. Set up.
And I think we've got an alternative clip in here somewhere as well, so let's see if we can get that to play through.
Oh yeah.
Nice. And so that's same trick, different location?
Yeah.
Different angle?
Yeah, different angle, different location. And I was playing around with doing a cross grab or just grabbing like safety or whatever on the same arms, same leg. Yeah.
And you're calling that's a safety because it's across the body?
No, that was a different variation, but the grab, I don't know, I just cross grab, I think. I don't really know what the proper name is, but.
We'll let someone in the comments give us a go. And
yeah.
Let's wrap it up and check out Jenny's clips. I do know that Jenny loves a spine. Can you tell us what you went for there?
So I was aiming for a seatbelt. I met a few rollerbladers there that night, and this was my last night, my last chance to get clips for this. And I still had nothing for the freestyle. I had no idea what to do. Grabs are not something I usually ever do. So I was just grasping at straws, and they were pulling them, and I was
grabbing
like,
at straws.
Maybe I should try that. So. Grabbing at straws. So I went for it and I landed it. So That no bails awesome. For this one.
Seatbelt is personally my favorite grab. I think I really like it because you have to get that twist in to make it happen, and it kind of makes you feel like you're freezing in the air as that rotation happens. But I hate landing things forwards, so I will always do my seatbelt grabs at a fakie. So the idea of doing this, and I know that me and you talk about this often when we do skate together, you will always go for that forward landing. And just to do this straight over a spine is very intimidating and very impressive, especially looking at the amount of height you got and bearing in mind that that's like a 6+ foot concrete spine. So very, very nicely done. Any questions, comments, snaps from the panel?
Oh, heck yeah, Bambi, awesome. At that roll, the grind.
Oh, thanks.
Awesome. All right. Well, we will wrap this final round up. So I'm just going to remind everyone in the voter section that you are now going to have 2 minutes to comment the name of the skater that you think nailed this category most. Every vote counts for 2 points in this final section. So be very considerate about who you think nailed this last trick, and then we will see you back here in a few minutes once the votes have been tallied up. Welcome back, and thank you everyone for voting. We are almost ready to wrap up our second ever episode of the Virtual Challenge Show. But before we do that, I want to get to know our skaters' skates a little bit better. So, Oji, would you mind telling us a bit about your setup?
So I have my skates right here. It's a DIY Vans build that I did myself. I've made 3 setups now, 3 or 4 builds, and all of them are a little bit janky, but they all fit my personality pretty well. And I do have to note that I used really thin metal for this build on the inside, and I did smash through and it completely break my skate off during the competition. So that was definitely scary and exciting at the same time to have a good friend help me put those back together.
Awesome. And let's check out Jess's skates.
So I've just got a Moxie Lolly with the standard stock plate, my disco blocks, the outlaw ones, some juice wheels, but I also really like the Fun Days, the Moxie Fun Day wheels. I normally have them on for my local bowl because it's pretty rough old concrete now. But no, I love them. I absolutely love them.
Awesome. And let's head over and check out Bambi's skates.
These are my skates and the pair that I've been skating primarily the past year, a little longer now. It's a Moxie Jack boot and a Reactor Pro plate. And I skate lots of different wheels. These are our Moxie Trick wheels that I use this week. I also obviously ride all the CIB wheels. I love them too. CIB block, which is, I love it, my favorite thing. And I also kind of have this set that I've been like playing with. It's my new set. Got some tester things on it, but I'm not totally comfortable yet. So this is the set I'm trying to break in.
That's awesome. Thank you for sharing those with us. And finally, let's check out Jenny's skates.
All right. So, I don't know if you're frozen on your end, but I can't see myself. There I am. So I like the antics. They were once beautifully custom, and a few too many wraparounds has made them not so shiny. But I like to say that I'm skating in clouds in these because they're so comfortable. Of course, the CIB sliders and wheels, the Vertex penny trucks, and the Avanti plate. I don't know. They're glorious and they work for me.
Awesome. Thank you everyone for sharing your skates with us. Before we get to announce, and I know everyone's very excited and eager to know who took it out, but I do just want to take a moment to give a big shout out to our sponsors who'll be sending a rad prize pack to the winner of this category. So we have S1 helmets, Moto Bearings, Heretic Skate, Grindstone, and of course CIAB. However did we get them on board? So our best in show skater will be rolling away with a package of rad prizes from all of these awesome brands. All right, without any further ado, I promise there won't be an ad break. We are going to introduce our winner. All right, virtual drum roll. So the winner of the second ever episode of the virtual challenge show for the Grabs category is Audrey. That is a great reaction.
No,
can you tell us how you're feeling right now?
Totally just shocked, honestly, I'm not gonna lie. Because there was some super advanced tricks, like I look up to Starlet and that pretzel grab, and oh my gosh, the grind oh my god, everybody, just the spines, and then like the grinds and grabs, like I actually attempted one and didn't even submit the video because I it was just not that, man, but I'm so shocked and like really thankful. Thank you.
You're most welcome. Oh, don't thank us. Anyway, thank the audience. We had a great group of voters on there that were commenting away, and it was really great. Everyone loved everybody's trick. So I'm really super impressed with everything you all brought to the table. I am going to take a second just to ask how you all felt about this experience. So I will finish with you, Audrey, since we just started with you. Jess, how do you feel about being on the virtual challenge show? Did you enjoy this process?
Yeah, very nervous, but I feel so honored to be part of this and to be skating alongside these other awesome skaters. I just can't believe I've had that chance.
Well, you're an incredible skater, and it's been so fun watching you over the years. And I mean, of course, with you and that pretzel grab, I'm so very stoked you submitted it. So thank you for sharing that with us. And I know that everyone really enjoyed seeing what you brought to the table for this. Bambi, how did you feel about being on the virtual challenge show?
Oh, so honored. I can't, like, when Lady Trample asked me to be on the Grinds episode, I was like, Grabs episode. I was like, nobody wants to watch my grabs, but anyways, so fun. This is the coolest format. I think this is awesome. It's like a time when I'm really missing events and skating with friends. So it was so cool to do something virtual that was a good motivation to go out there and just have fun skating.
Well, thank you so much for being here. And I will say that everyone wants to see you skate. As someone that has had the pleasure of skating with you over the years, you're always such a pleasure to skate with, and you always really step it up. So take that back. I'm taking it back.
Oh, okay, I took it. Sorry.
My Jenny, camera was
glitching. I got all confused.
No, you're all good. Jenny, how did you feel about being on the virtual challenge show?
I think it was such a super cool experience. I was absolutely honored to get the call from you too. And being thrown into grabs totally pushes me out of my comfort zone. But as you personally know, I really feed into challenges, and so this was really exciting for me. And I haven't really skated a whole lot since the whole coronavirus thing started, so it was really a good push to get me back into the parks regularly, and that's been super awesome. And this was great, and you stacked the roster here. Like, everybody was, these tricks were amazing. You guys, kudos to all of you. Those were beautiful.
I'm going to echo what Jenny said there. Absolutely kudos to all of you. Each of you absolutely deserved the right to be here. You're incredible skaters who really, I am super impressed with the tricks that I saw. I know that everyone that was watching was really impressed with everything that they saw. The comments are going crazy. I personally look up to all four of you as skaters, and it was an absolute pleasure to have you here. You just absolutely kicked ass. So, but butts were kicked. I'm still learning. Oh dear. Okay. Audrey, one last question for you. How do you feel about being on the virtual challenge show? Did you enjoy this experience?
Totally. It definitely, I worked really, really hard. A lot of these works that I don't practice a lot, but I knew that I could kick them out. So a lot of sessions, a lot of supports from like my best friends. Dee woke up countless hours to come like help me film at like 6 a.m. My boyfriend, and just honestly, I had so much fun doing it. And again, the virtual challenge show was like so, so much fun. No phones or filmers were broken in the process.
But I'm not convinced.
I was actually shocked. I don't know how my phone didn't crush again. But no, I had so much fun. And honestly, like I was so wrecked after submitting all these clips. Like, I don't think I slept harder than that in my whole life.
Well, thank you again for being a part of the show. Congratulations on taking away Best in Show. And thank you again to all of our guests. It really was such a pleasure to have you here. So without any further ado, we will wrap up the second episode of Virtual Challenge Show. I would like to remind everyone that these episodes air every 2 weeks, so we will be announcing the next category and meeting our next contestants on the CIB socials, so make sure you stay tuned to those. Be sure to subscribe to Twitch so that you know when the next episode is coming out, so that you can make sure that you are in that feed voting live for our skaters. Thank you so much for being here. I've been Lady Trample, and I will catch you all in a few weeks.